Burkina Faso has sent shockwaves through the global automotive industry with the unexpected launch of its first 100% indigenous electric vehicle, EV, the itaoua. In a move that has left experts both stunned and impressed, this West African nation has boldly entered the race for sustainable transportation, challenging the dominance of global EV giants and placing Africa firmly on the map as a hub of green innovation. The itaoua is not just any electric vehicle, it is fully solar-powered, a groundbreaking feat for a developing country that has often been overshadowed in technological advancements. Designed and manufactured in the prestigious district of Ouaga 2000, the vehicle is a testament to Burkina Faso's commitment to sustainability and technological self-reliance. With an impressive range of 330 kilometers on a single charge and a rapid charging capability that reaches full capacity in just 30 minutes, the itaoua is poised to disrupt Africa's growing EV market and redefine the continent's approach to green mobility. The manufacturer behind this revolutionary project emphasized that the itaoua was built with efficiency, reliability, and sustainability in mind. The itaoua electric vehicle is designed to provide a sustainable mobility solution, reducing dependence on fossil fuels while promoting clean energy alternatives in Africa, the company stated. At a time when African nations are battling energy crisis and environmental challenges, this EV presents itself as a beacon of hope and progress. Africa's shift towards electric vehicles is gaining momentum, with the continent's EV market projected to reach a staggering $25.4 billion by 2030. Yet, while China, the United States, and Europe accounted for 95% of global EV sales in 2023, African nations have often been viewed as lagging behind. The launch of the itaoua proves that this perception is rapidly becoming outdated. Burkina Faso has now positioned itself among a select group of African nations taking bold strides toward a cleaner future. The impact of this achievement extends beyond technological innovation. The launch of itaoua is expected to boost local manufacturing, create thousands of jobs, and inspire a new generation of African engineers, designers, and entrepreneurs. This homegrown success story has demonstrated that Africa does not need to rely on foreign imports to compete in the evolving landscape of sustainable transportation. Instead, nations can harness their own ingenuity and resources to build vehicles tailored to their unique environmental and economic challenges. This development comes amid a wave of EV initiatives sweeping across the continent. Botswana, for instance, recently unveiled its first locally assembled electric vehicles in Gaborone through a collaboration between the Botswana Institute for Technology Research and Innovation and two Chinese automakers. Meanwhile, countries like South Africa, Morocco, Kenya, Tanzania, and Ethiopia have been aggressively expanding their EV infrastructure, each striving to carve out a niche in the emerging market. South Africa continues to lead the charge with its advanced charging infrastructure and import policies favoring electric mobility. Morocco, on the other hand, is making waves in EV battery production, leveraging its vast renewable energy resources to power the next generation of green transport. Kenya and Rwanda are pioneering electric motorcycles and taxis, transforming urban mobility with cleaner, more efficient alternatives. Ethiopia is expanding its electric public transport networks, while Angola, Ghana, and Benin are laying the groundwork for full-scale EV adoption through policy incentives and infrastructure investments. But Burkina Faso's itaoua stands apart. Unlike many African nations that rely on foreign partnerships to advance their EV sectors, Burkina Faso has proven that indigenous innovation can thrive without external dependencies. This bold move signals a shift in the balance of power, proving that Africa is not merely a consumer of technological advancements, but a formidable creator in its own right. The itaoua also highlights a broader trend, Africa's march toward energy independence. As the continent grapples with volatile fuel prices, power shortages, and climate change concerns, EVs present a viable solution to reduce reliance on imported fossil fuels. with solar-powered capabilities. The itaoua is particularly suited to Africa's climate, harnessing the continent's abundant sunlight to provide clean, affordable transportation. This alone makes Burkina Faso's innovation a game-changer. However, challenges remain. Infrastructure development, particularly in charging stations and battery disposal, must keep pace with the rise of electric vehicles. Governments must implement policies that incentivize adoption while ensuring that electricity grids can handle the increasing demand. Additionally, affordability remains a critical factor. Can locally manufactured EVs remain competitive against cheaper, imported alternatives? Yet, despite these hurdles, Burkina Faso's announcement has set a precedent that will be hard to ignore. The itaoua is more than just a car. It is a symbol of Africa's potential, a reminder that the continent has the ingenuity, talent, and drive to compete on the world stage. It challenges the notion that high-tech industries are the sole domain of Western and Asian powerhouses. The global automotive industry would be wise to take note. With the rapid acceleration of EV adoption across Africa and governments actively investing in green transportation policies, the itaoua may just be the beginning of a homegrown revolution. If Burkina Faso, a nation that many never considered a contender in the electric vehicle space, can achieve this, what's stopping the rest of Africa from following suit? In the coming years, expect to see more African nations breaking barriers in green innovation. The itaoua is not just Burkina Faso's triumph, it is Africa's moment to shine. And as the continent takes control of its technological destiny, the world will have no choice but to watch in awe. So what do you make of Burkina Faso launching its first indigenous electric vehicle, the itaoua? Share your thoughts and insights in the comments section below. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to the New Africa Wealth channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our informative future videos.